Hey guys, this is Laura, and I have Laura Faye Glass, and today I thought I would show you how to make a Valentine heart. And the first thing I'm going to do is just start heating up some glass. My heart today, I think, is going to be orange with some red and a little bit of lime green. Oops. So first thing, I'm going to just make a little paddle out of some molten glass. So this is my orange. So we've got the glass turning to a bright white, which is what we want. As I have enough, I'm going to use my little mashers to mash it. So there's a nice flat round paddle, but I kind of want it to be a square. So I'm going to take that, heat it up, and just make it to a square. Square it up over here. So now I'm bringing in the red color. They all look the same in the flame, don't they? Get it to that molten state, so I want another little hot white ball of glass. I'm going to just put that right on top of there. Alright, so now I'm going to take my favorite paring knife tool and just kind of smush that. All fuse together and put another good squish. Square it back up. Now I'm going to take the lime green and I'm just going to make a little border all the way around. That'll give us a nice little green stripe. So we are going to twist this all together. It's going to be kind of cool. So it's red on one side, orange on the other side, and a lime green all the way around the edge. So now all we need to do is cover it with clear, and we can make our heart. Clear warmed up. Start to see it drew. Big old glob. Alright, here we go. So just putting that big glob of clear right on top. Kind of a mound on there, so then it really shows up, the swirl shows up nicely in the clear. That clear really, and I'm just going to melt that in a little bit, but I'm warming up my clear again, so I need to do it on the other side. So we're not dragging that green at all, it's still in a nice stripe around the edge, nice border. Because I'm keeping this warm, but I'm not heating it up enough to disturb that when we pull it down there. And the more molten you get this, piece of glass, you'll have less air bubbles when you apply it to this piece. So course we can capture air bubbles in there pretty easily, and we will have some, but the hotter you get this piece, the better off it is. So it's just globs and globs. It's not hard. Just warming it up, warming it up. And then I'm going to attach this like a little handle over here, because it's going to start getting really soupy. And I don't want that to just drop off the end. And it could. And it has. So I'm going to try to get this nice evenly, a nice even heat in this. So just keep kind of turning it, using gravity to keep it in that nice little blob. It's all melted in. So I'm going to get ready to twist it. And this isn't like your normal twisty where you're going to twist and twist and twist. I just want to give a few pretty little decorative twists. So I'm gonna, now that I've got the twist, I want to kind of make it back into that smaller ball again. So I'm going to use gravity and just so this orange, I'm gonna pull that off. So it's time to say goodbye to the orange. The different colors coming out. So now I'm taking another clear rod and I'm going to attach that on there. So to make the heart, two shoulders and the heart, I need to take this piece off. We're getting to the fun part though, where you actually get to see that it's a heart. Alright, it's starting to get to a nice round shape. Rounded shape, I should say. I still want that the bottom of it to be narrow, of course, because that's where your heart forms. Now I'm looking at it right now to see, okay, which side do I like the best? What do I want it to, which side do I want to be front? What do I want on the side? So there's a little air bubble right there, so I think I'm going to put that on the side. It's less noticeable. And into, just kind of condense it into more of a ball. This little guy is made of graphite, so it can take the heat and it doesn't leave a ton of marks on it. See that swirl coming in with the green? Oh, so cool. Love that. So now to get the nice heart shape, you know what? I'm going to shape that one more time. And I just stick that guy in there and I kind of go back and forth just to get the nice shape. Paring knife again, and then I just start pushing, like it's, I don't like to push it all the way until I can double check and make sure that they're fairly even. I like one side to be a little bit bigger than the other, but I also like it to be pretty symmetrical. With just a slight noticeable difference in shoulder size. Okay. So now we're getting a heart shape. Upside down heart. So this will be our pendant handle, and I'm just looking to see if this one is naturally bigger. So I'm going to put the handle over on this side, so that shoulder is a little bit bigger. So. Keep heating everything up so it doesn't crack. It'd be more fun if you could just like design all the time and not have to worry about keeping it warmed up. So if it was easy, everybody would do it. So I'm just kind of forming that into a loop so that you can put this on a chain or maybe a piece of ribbon or a piece of leather. Okay. Using a dental pick just to make sure that that hole stays open. Believe me, they've closed it before and I've had to redo them, and it's just not my favorite thing to do. Okay, just making sure that's really attached. I'm going to take the whole thing off of the mandrel, or off of the... The last second, I'm going to grab this little handle and pull it off. It's just about time. Right, so here we have a heart with the little leg is a little tail there is a little long, so I'm gonna take that off, but I'm not gonna take a lot of it off. But I have to keep this guy nice and warm, otherwise he will crack. And there is our finished heart. Okay, now I have to get this in the kiln quickly, so I will put a picture on it tomorrow. Have it tomorrow after it spends the night in the kiln. That should be pretty. Thanks, guys.